gone before. Oh, until you want some more. It's all right if the band player. Say, aye, say, oh, oh, oh. Say, aye, one more time. Ow! Say, aye, say, aye, I saw it. Look, girl, you already know what I'm talking about. I see it in your eyes, you can't do it out. Oh, you might be surprised what I do it now. Now, now, oh, oh, I said I love you. You already know what I'm talking about. I love it. I see it in your eyes, you can't do it out. And you might be surprised what I do it now. Now, and now. Bring it down for a little time. Uh-huh. I see you are mine, let's go. Girl, you already know. Ow. I see it in your eyes, you can't do it out. And you might be surprised. Whoa. I said, look, girl, you already know. I see it in your eyes. Whoa. And you might be surprised what I do now, 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 now. Yo, Tony, say, ay, 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 yeah. Come on, a little louder. Ay, 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 yeah. Say, oh, 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 oh. Oh. I am Brian Lamar. We are Dead Stars. Thank you so much for attending Gage tonight. Madam T.L. Crawford.
You guys give it up again one more time for Mr. Brian Hamilton. Wasn't that amazing? Wow. You guys, welcome to Gage. Thank you so much for coming out this afternoon. I know this weekend is filled with so many wonderful events, and you guys chose to be here, so give yourselves a round of applause tonight. Let's hear it for yourselves. Thank you. That's how you feel about yourself? Let's hear it for yourselves. Come on. Woo! All right. You guys, we have an amazing event tonight at the Living Arts. Thanks so much for Tulsa Juneteenth, for Living Arts, for having us apart, Selah Productions and Selah Model and Company. You guys, we're bringing forward artists like Mr. Brian Hamilton here. Live original music. I want you to remember that. Live original music. That means he wrote the music himself, okay? Produced it. His band is incredible. You guys, let's give it up one more time for True Artistry in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Wonderful. We also have, from Langston University, a wonderful speaker, Dr. Sass, and he's going to come and speak to you guys about Juneteenth, about the history, about our culture, not only as a city, as a state, but a world, and what we're trying to do with Gage, and as a society, what are we trying to do here? Are we here for live music and just to have a good time? You guys have all the weekend and the rest of the night to do that, to go outside and sweat like crazy. But tonight, we really want you guys to leave here fulfilled and educated and reminded about our history and what are we going to do moving forward, which is unity, coming together, building a bridge. And so that's what we want you guys to leave here with tonight. So I'm going to ask at this time, if you see an empty chair, if you can just move forward. We want to make sure we capture you guys' attention. We want to make sure that it's all filled up. We're going to be filming this and putting it on the website, so we want to make sure you guys are included. So if we can get all the front rows to be filled up, we'd appreciate that if you guys don't mind. Terrific. All right. Thank you so much, you guys. I'm going to introduce to you guys Dr. Sasson, and I'm going to come back and let you know exactly who was in this show for you tonight. We've got live painting with Chris Mantle. You're going to give it up for Chris because he's coming on now. Brian Crump, he's out there doing an actual live portrait on a model who's going to be dancing for you guys. It's going to be incredible. So I'm going to come back and just kind of remind you a little bit of what Tulsa Juneteenth and Living Arts and poet Tony B. We've got Ridden Quincy. We've got Claire Collins. If you guys know these people, Fatoti, let me hear it, okay? Amazing, amazing. So at this moment, I'm going to give you guys just a little bit of education. So better go ahead and bring in Dr. Sasson. Thank you so much. You guys give him a round of applause.
Good day. Good day to everybody. Peace, salam, shalom. Let us take a second today as we reflect and remember those who are not with us, our brothers in humanity, that through hate are no longer part of our lives. From Charleston to California, to the streets of Chicago, to the corners of Detroit, hate has taken so many human beings from our lives. We cannot forget. We must not forget. Juneteenth is a celebration of liberation, but for 400 years, we have failed in our responsibility to liberate all people. We practice what we preach only when it's convenient for ourselves. So it is important today, this celebration, that we remember all those who are lost to violence on our streets, to the institutional racism that still exists in our lives. Every day, I walk the streets of Greenwood Avenue. I'm also on the Chamber of Greenwood, and it is our responsibility to welcome you to Juneteenth. We are also one of the sponsors. But as the board of directors, every day that I walk those stairs on Greenwood Avenue, it reminds me of the tears, the suffering, and the souls that were lost a long time ago. It's evident in the scars and the bricks on Greenwood Avenue. But what also is evident in the streets that surround Greenwood Avenue is the resilience of the human spirit, the compassion that we have for others, and the mission that we have to heal a fractured universe. There's an old Hebrew saying called Tikkun Olam. It means to heal a fractured universe. And that is part of our responsibility in celebration and in remembrance. The arts, the spoken word, the dance, photography. It has given us voices. It has given the voice to the voiceless. It has given us the opportunity to see and feel the spirit of those who have not been able to express themselves in many multiple ways. It is important that we understand the connectiveness. I'm not a historian. When I was asked by Marissa to come and speak on the history of Juneteenth, we cannot just look at history as a whitewashed event that happens in our textbooks, because history traditionally is written by the victors, it is written by the oppressors, and it is written with an agenda. History is not something that is an analog, black or white. History is us. History is the understanding how connected the oppressor and the oppressed has traditionally been intertwined. And I think it's important events like this that gives us a chance to come together and understand our connectiveness and to understand that it is important to build a bridge, not a silo. For if we build silos around one narrative, one experience, those silos could be emptied with hate in a moment. But if we build bridges of material, heterogeneous material, they stand the strength of time. We must build bridges of with each other's spirit, love, and compassion in mind. And the arts gives us the opportunity to come together and experience that. The youth, the young, and the old coming together and understanding our collective history. We must not forget. I would walk this journey in life, not as a historian, but as a healer. My work at Langston is not to preserve history, but to make sure it never happens again. It is important to me and my students and my friends that we reach out to each other and understand our role in going forward as a people. But first, we have to acknowledge the reality of the day. We are making choices each day to live in how we live. I pray that we all live with a level of compassion, a level of understanding, and a level of commitment that never again, never more, will we let violence, hate, segregation, separation destroy who we are as human beings. So we today, on this joyous but solemn occasion, we recognize Juneteenth. But it was a year ago yesterday in Charleston. It was a week ago in Orlando. It is on the streets of Detroit and Chicago that every day is played out, where what happens when people choose hate over compassion. There's an old African saying that I use, and I'll close with that. I see you. I see you means I value you. And when I see you, that means I listen to you. I understand, or at least I try to understand, your journey. Juneteenth is a way for us to remember the race riots of 1921, the Tuscan Airmen of the 1940s, the Jim Crow rules that have not been erased in many minds and many hearts. We can do better. We must do better. We have to do better. Shalom, salam, peace.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Give it up one more time. Thank you so much. We're so much closer to getting into Gage. All right, so I just want to read off one more time. I know you guys have programs, but I want to make sure you are reminded of who all has spent a lot of hard work, time, and energy to make sure that this vision, this message is going out to you guys. So we've got choreography, professional choreography, Aura Mott Dance. We've got Monique Sims. You guys, if you want to clap, go right ahead. I know you haven't seen it yet, but trust me, first and second scene, you're going to be clapping and screaming and hollering, and that's what we love. So we've also got poetry by Tony B, and he's also one of the chair for Living Arts. We've got Ridden Quincy, Claire Collins, Fatoti, Rashari. We've also got live painting. All right, and I mentioned that before. We've got, that's going on with Chris Mantle, and it's going to be right here on stage. And he's going to be building a beautiful painting for you guys that will be on sale, and 50% of that goes back to Tulsa Juneteenth. So you guys give that a round for him. That's amazing. All right. We also have a live painter, Brian Crump. He does some amazing body paint, and I like to call it body art because he's incredible. And you guys, he's actually right here in the corner. Can you wave, Brian? He's amazing, you guys. All the way in from Oklahoma City. Phenomenal. Dancer Dina is going to be wearing his live painting, and she's going to be at her doing some phenomenal, very emotional pieces. And so we also have designers. Danae Clark, you guys give it up for her. She's also Miss Strut 2016 and 15. We have Black Wall Street Market, and that's by Billy Parker. And we also have jewelry that's been provided by Copper Signatures. You guys, this young lady who makes this handmade jewelry that I'm wearing is going to be seen also in scene two when the models come out. And it is handmade copper with precious stone. It's beautiful. She has lupus, and she dedicated her life to repairing everyone that she come in contact with her gift. So isn't this gorgeous, you guys? So we're bringing you not only a message and education, we're also bringing you artistry. We're bringing you handcrafted, soul manifested. So I want you to really experience that from a different level. So how do we know you're enjoying yourself? How do we know that these models from Selah Model and Company are really, really entertaining you guys? How do we know that the designers have done an excellent job in your eyes? We know that from your hands when you clap. We know that from your eyes when they glisten, and your smile, and your body language and your energy. All right, so when they come out, we want to hear it. This is not the show where you sit and be, you know, just dainty. We want you to get excited. So when Brian Hamilton, who's come in and done all the undertone music for these poems, when you're feeling that and you hear something that those chords spike in you, let them know. Interaction is what we want for you guys at Gage. We want you to leave with a piece of Gage, which is a token of freedom, you guys. And so leave with that. Share your motivation, you guys, and let them know that you are enjoying yourself at Gage 2016. So excited that you could be here. I'm so excited for the speakers and the dancers. We've got Denaya, Danny, we've got Kenyelli Ellis, we've got Kayla Jackson, Alexander McDaniel, Monique Sims, of course, Ivory Sample. We also have the model Siri Morales. We've got Kyra White, Ashley Marks, Suwan Whitelock, Robbie Gale, Sanjay. We've got Breanne Taylor. We've got Jenna Hillman, Deshante, Davana, Leslie, Jacqueline, Shanna B, Nisha C, Raquel, Lauren, Nyla, and Jada. And also, I neglected to mention that I have some handmade clothing that's going to also be in the show with Selah Couture. And that's going to be the last two scenes. And without saving the best for last, of course, without any further ado, I want to make sure that before you guys, we jump into this, you understand that the crew that's here, we've got some amazing production teams. We've got Brett Smith with Selah Modeling Company, Alexandra Slack. We've got Whitney Kendall, Michelle Boeing. We've got Grace Walker, Marissa Joy with Oramat. We've also got James Sims. So we've got an amazing crew, you guys. And don't forget Mr. Steve Liggett, who is so wonderful, you guys. If we can give him a round of applause and thank you for his generosity and his support with Tulsa Juneteenth. And we are going to start, you guys. Are you ready? All right. If you're ready, I want to hear you let me know. I want you to hear say Gage Juneteenth. All right. And you got to say it extremely loud. And if it's not loud enough, we won't start. Okay. You guys ready? You want to say on the count of three, Gage Juneteenth. All right. Here we go. One, two, three. Gage Juneteenth. All right. Let's hear it.
Blue, the color I love most in all its many flavors. I savor the shades from midnight to pastel, like the welcoming sky signaling better days ahead. Blue comforts me, but blue can be a sad mood. Blue is the color of pain that morphs to black like the sky when it's angry with dark clouds and ready to unleash its fury. Black, the color of the whips that beat the hope out of my father's hearts. Black, the color of the fists that came crashing into my mother's faces. Black, the color of pain, the color of gloom, but then too, the sight that brings me joy because it coats the face of my one true love. Black elate CEOs. Black is the color of the shoes that carry most of us to our fates, but those black shoes bring red as a gang of angry young men kick the lifeblood out of another. Red, the color that signals the end of a life as it flows mournfully into the street. Red, the color of the people who bore the brunt of the making of this country. Red, the color of anger, the color of embarrassment, then too, the color of power and excitement as blood red fluid fills the yin and yang of two people drawn by a flimsy red negligee, making red the color of life. Yes, red is the color of life, but also the color that signals the death of so many things green. The land suffers because the red must be fed. But green is abundant. Green is the color of the most successful life forms on this planet. It's the verdant color of health, but green can be nauseating. See, green was the color of those intriguing eyes that turned others the same color with envy. Green is the color of money. Green is the color of the money used by white hands to slap the rest of the world into submission. White, a color blinding that sometimes blinds its owner. White, the color of fear, the color of surrender, but you know it's the color that sparks victory. Don't shoot till you see the whites of his eyes. White of the teeth that we'd all have to have. White is my t-shirt, so fresh and so clean, clean. White was my page before I began, so white can be a clean slate. I said all this to drop the message that a color can represent several different viewpoints, some good, some bad, just like people. These colors I've cited come together symbolically, red, white, and blue for America, black, red, and green for the African diaspora. But can they mix? Can we successfully blend the diaspora into America without smothering the Africa? I, for one, do not want America to become a melting pot, some bland soup of the same old damn thing from sea to shining sea. See, I love pizza and hamburgers and jerk chicken and tabbouleh and mugu gai pan and roasted corn and curried vegetables and sauerkraut and tacos and sweet potato pie. You know, the foods that reflect the combination of colors that say this is America, Jack, the most diverse, most powerful country on this planet. This land is our land, my land, your land. I am African American, but we've got Native Americans, Asian Americans, Caucasian Americans, Hispanic Americans, Arab Americans, Jewish Americans, Island Americans, and more. We are all Americans. Sometimes we forget that. This is for the red, the white, the blue, and all the colors that dwell within its borders. This piece is for America. One country, many cultures, one love, baby. One love. Thank you.
We were so close, there was no room. We bled inside each other's wombs. Some came to dance, and some came to pray. Or they came to chase the blues away, the blues away.
Music is in my ancestral DNA. My blood dances to heartbeats. My pulse quickens and sinks with the sway of hips. I readily offer these limbs to rhythms. Drink the beats and ventilate in the notes that flow like puppet strings into my subconscious. Primordial rhythms from the motherland compelling me to get up and show everybody that I love to dance. And when I dance, it's not because I'm happy or sad. Dancing doesn't erase my blues or ease my pains. Dancing sets me free, releases me into a realm where cares, troubles, money, and status become non-sequiturs. Where a destination, where you're going, loses all meaning because music is the engine. This dance floor, our chariot, and all the fuel you need is that look on your face that says, I love to dance. Now I know I'm not Fred Astaire, Bojangles, Chris Brown, or Michael Jackson. I won't jabberwocky you with my choreography, but watch me. See, I move like I got kungas dancing in my veins. My feet stalk the dance floor like a warrior tracking grizzlies. And even if I happen to cruise like a koala bear on crack, watch my eyes. Taste this smile, feel my mojo, and you'll realize I'm the baddest mamma jamma on the floor, baby, because I love to dance. It's like the notes play this sensual melody that's not quite erotic, but oh so arousing as the music slides fingers across my body, wraps tightly around fond memories, and I succumb. Give in to the lure of those soft brown eyes beaming seductive into mine. The flash of a smile, that look on her face when I take her hand and we move like we were born for this. Embracing the concepts of polyrhythms and syncopated beats, we spin, we drop, we kick, we gyrate, turning our whole bodies into celebrations. With moisture now kissing our skins, I pull her close. Sync with that glorious purring from within, and it's on, y'all. So come on, dance with me. Dance with me. Come on.
that we all see the days as the sirens will scream out loud. As we come to the home and they burrow past the view of now. No chords, leave your balcony for more. They loved you better before, then you stood up from the crowd and they salt on the pudge. And they all take a pain when you fly up and they remain. And you shout from the lows, they like to just as you were. Yeah, oh, just as you were.
I can't take my eyes off. Please do not get offended. I'm not staring. I'm studying every iota of your aura. And I can feel the energy of your inner me emanating, and I cannot help but bask in the glow of your radiance. You are so beautiful. I will paint a portrait of your perfection on the inside of my eyelids just so that I can see you when I blink. Woman, even 0.3 seconds is too long to be out of view of you. Oh, and peekaboo is definitely taboo, cause I don't even want to play like I'm taking my eyes off of you. And so I take 24-hour energy shots and park no dose, because sleeping will require my eyes to close and lose consciousness, and dreaming of a dream that has already come true is simply redundant. But even if I were to succumb to slumber, my third eye would still be watching over you. Woman, anyone who thinks that you're just good looking obviously has not got the good look in you. Lady, you are super fine, delicious, mixed with sexy, yellowdoses. I need a steady flow of you, I can't take you just in doses. You are so stunning. I wish that I can see you in 4D so that I can scan every curve and crevice of your stature with this all at once. I want to gorge myself on every portion of your gorgeous. Your countenance is a beautiful contradiction of hot and flashy yet cool and sassy. Woman, you turn me on and get me off simultaneously. But I don't want to just look at you. I want to look after you. I want to provide and protect and make vows before a pastor with you. When I'm looking at you, I'm looking forward to who God created you to be while still appreciating the imperfections of the past that made you, you. Your smile makes me smile because every laugh line is like a titillating lyric telling the tales of your happy times. I'm listening, baby. If I were to look away from you for even a moment, I would mourn that moment and pray for time to rewind and reincarnate that moment. And I would be there for you every time your lovely image is reborn. Amore comes to mind when I think of you. Your beauty is like fine wine. I get inebriated when I drink of you. You intoxicate. I love to see that look on your face when you see the sincerity in my eyes when I tell you that I love you. I mean, even if I could, I still wouldn't. But why would I try to take my eyes off of you? Your fine self.
And we're going to create a moment here. If you could just repeat after me, yes, sir. If you could sing that with us. Was the night that came to get me and take me home. The man that I was, they remember, but that man ain't here no more. And the boys that cried, oh, oh, they cried, oh. Tempest raised a ship me out to sea, but she raised her hands and wars they stopped and oceans bled out over me. See, I sold my soul to a goddess now, and I'm held captive by her charm, and she wants me close now, or just to wipe off every memory from my heart. And the boy they cried, oh. Oh, they cried, oh. Nah, nah, baby, nah, nah, nah. Oh, they cried, oh, oh, oh. They cried, oh, 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 oh. Ah. Here we go. Oh, talk. your hands, they touch my face, I do remember. And a secret's made the way down to my chest, nah, nah, nah. And I feel as though that I'm no longer prisoner. Well, she promised me some things I can't forget. So where is the golden crown she said I'd have? Oh, these shackles are broken, oh, I just can't look back, no, no. I'm letting her go, she's taking the hold. She's taking me close, she's holding me close, not letting me go. Like, oh, 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 oh.
I wanted a picture to discuss. Paint one, so I'm trying. Paintbrush, canvas accented with a crimson blood blush, touched up just a little. Set of eyes in the middle, brown with a tear stream rush. Currents of the Delta's power symbolically symbolize hush. The painter's doing something new. Take a little blue and black, indigo and ebony to mix with the blood. See, it's stained differently. Pain, misery, Cain. Remember we was just on the bank of the river yesterday. Don't kill, chain memories. Chained memories, bruises beneath the cheekbone match the cold stripes on the back of this image. If it was 3D, you can bear witness to 8 weeks of no cotton fielding just to give enough time for scabbing to cover over the open laceration and healing. If it ain't nothing wrong with your legs, nigga, stop your bitching and complaining. Watch, watch. It looks like he's painting raining. Or it could be when the blue coats came in. Look, they got niggas fought with the Yanks and we thought Jesus was real. This the answer to all we've been praying. But you said don't be scared that night when screaming came from over Miss Daisy. They raped Miss Daisy, came with brethren. Same mama and daddy, same Elohim, team same and caught by the same preacher arm. Remember Cain, River Jordan, we baptized the choir saying, you must remember we ain't insane. And we ain't to blame. Please don't squeeze it. Don't scream revenge over me. I know you're angry. My nigga, they call us niggas and coons and baboons and three-fifths of being humane. The beef we held more value than you and me, bro. We still in chains. It's ingrained, my nigga. They signed up together to fly planes, my nigga. We wore them stripes proud overseas. The women love the color of our skin. We felt free, my nigga. Agreed to come back to this motherfucker when we put our life on the line for this motherfucker. Our stomach was sick, my nigga. They called us. We made a little bit of change, and we went to Alabama, signed up for that experiment. Syphilis, family portraits were banned. Mama gone, Cain. Mama gone. They don't even acknowledge daddy no more, Cain. 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 It's just me and you, Cain. It's just me and you, Cain. It's just me and you, Cain.
It's just me and you.
We have one more song before our intermission. I mean, the song is called This Life. We hope you've enjoyed the show thus far. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, let's go. Hands up. I can't hear you. Matt, make a sing for me, baby. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Oh, whoa, whoa. Take it from me, you're better off my friend. Another one flies to the end. You better believe in what is said to the end. Oh, 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 this life, it will tell you apart. Oh, 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 this life. Hey! It will tell you apart. Another one calls from the gates. They're wanting the toes, hold the toes to the plate. They wanna be told to be great. You see them on sign on the way to the grave. Oh, 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 this life, it will tell you apart. Oh, 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 this life, it will tear you up.
Tear you apart.
Give it up for our models.
It will tear you apart. Tear you apart.
Yeah, stars, let's rock it out. Here we go.
Tear you apart. Tear you apart. Tear you apart.
All right, all my people, I want to hear you say.
Say, oh, yeah, 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 yeah. You say, oh,
can't hear you.
Oh. You say, oh, you say, oh,
I love it. You say, clap. Go, dog.
So much.
Gage 2016. What are you guys thinking about it so far? Let me hear the energy now. Yes. You see what I mean when I say education? You guys really remembering our history. And the next part is how we come together and how we work as a unit and how we build that bridge. So you guys, I want to invite you to intermission. You can come over here to Nore and see the wonderful art exhibits that we have. Don't go anywhere because the best has yet to been delivered. You guys do not want to miss this powerful ending. All right, you guys, we'll take a 10-minute. We'll go over here to Nore. You guys, please enjoy our artists that we have that's brought their beautiful artistry with them, you guys. And you guys, we're going to go ahead and listen to some more Bryant Hamilton. And if you guys are interested, please get in our step and repeat area, take some photos. They're gonna be on Facebook. We'll get your information and we'll send it to you and tag you in it. You guys, enjoy Gage 2016.
To get a better view of your twisted point of view, the black in me must speak to the back of you, since political correctness with the dash of cowardice askew what you are permitted to publicly spew about how you truly view those of a darker hue. Phew. But that is nothing new. So since you are so used to sending blacks to the back, let me mosey on back there. Back to the insidious lair where some folks here dare to believe that other human beings deserve to be ensnared if the tone of their skin is less fairer than theirs. And oh, it is quite obvious that you are lactose intolerant because you ramble off racial epithets under your breath like bubble guts ready to defecate hatred every time you see me. In the back of your mind, educated, outspoken black folk like me are either uppity or lucky. Or lucky that our uppity butts don't get locked up on trumped up charges or choked to the brink of extinction one innocent black or brown person at a time, even though we were unarmed and complying. And if it wasn't for cell phone videos, y'all would still think that we were lying. Oh, and you be fronting like you don't secretly envy me. Like you don't be soaking up UV rays to look like me. Like you don't be standing in a mirror trying to mimic my style and vocals in an atrocious attempt to jack my swag adociousness. And oh, I find it rather ironic how you put me down for being black or brown when some white women's physical description of their quintessential man is tall, dark, and handsome. 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
Really good friend named Tyrone. Yet I bet that you would disown your own daughter if she brought a black man home. Because in the back of your mind, I was convicted on sight. An African American who can't be a full-blooded human in a land who considers him 3/5 of a man. In an amended constitution that constitutes that my humanity is diluted with delusions of being equal to you. From your frontal to occipital to lobe, you and the rest of your Ku Klux Klan cannot stand it when I take stances in my stances and demand to be reprimanded for your crimes against humanity. In the back of your mind, my application and resume will decline the moment you notice my ethnic name, regardless of my education, qualifications, or acclaim. In the back of your mind, the lack of me trying is what is keeping me from succeeding in the same oppressive system that makes a Caucasian villain the victim when he murders an unarmed black kid for strolling in the land of the free with nothing but candy, tea, and audacity. In the back of some of y'all's repugnant minds, did Trayvon Martin really deserve to be deceased? See, in the back of your mind, on the end of a line is where I'm supposed to be. Either shackled to your devious deceptions or swinging like an anatomical ornament from your pagan trees. Well, I really admire Negroes, yeah, as long as they're running or shooting free throws. But I see through the false niceties and icy glares into the nightmares that did not wait for slumber. Into the last storefront window whose reflectance reflected flames and hatred as Black Wall Street was burned and plundered. So now that I have exposed the weeds and tilled the uncommon ground, I'm going to plant my seeds of success where I'm supposed to, so that you can find me firmly parked in the front of you like Rosa. I'm a soldier, and I'm not free because you set me free. I'm free because God created me to be.
counting change, counting on change, burden heavy, cashing in change, doing time, counting times money, doing time, counting times money, doing time, counting times money. Everybody obsessed with the cocoa lately. Elephant tusks in Africa, your teeth white as. I've never rode a lover I didn't like. I like my women book smart and nasty. I like my men like I like my art, framed and painted like I'm living with this paragraph, but I can't serve this sentence. Doing time, counting times, money, doing time, count times, money, doing time, count times, money, doing time, count times, money, but I ain't mad, honey, cause we got this cosmic connection. Like rain meets concrete, smoke greet fire, teeth grind smiley, we buy bags from Whitey, we kick rocks like nosebleed heat, blue, red, police, D say it's hot, take the side streets, drive me, derive me like this cocaina derived from something, tastes like baking soda and rust, tastes like powder and dust, tastes like 4 years doing powder to dust, like who introduced us anyway, hi, nice to meet you, I'm streetless lavender dust of days destroyed, hide time like she kills, like her name inmate, third eye concentrate, got stuck in a state of awake, Sunday spent to shame, my bunkie bites her bottom lip. A native tongue wraps around her neck, Eve's apple chokes, criminal eats rodents in dark, double parked felonies scar her arms. She orange like 148 other women smell. She smell like the crumbs up under your nails, like my who do your nails, whittled weapons gripping a crucifix, wishing she had a Xanax right now. Been going up for so long, it's time to come down in the county. Doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money. Sing, same land she come from, same land you stole, leather of the hide of her ancestors stuffed, hear her name, hair her braid, ask her a question, ancient tongue locked up, doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money. In bed buggy cuddy apartment, smoking borrowed Marlboro's, butt of the joke conjunction. She's standing at the corner of tell, don't tell, but you look like you know death fool. Could you deny that it could have been you? You hanging hungry altars, orange amphetamine moons, or tongue shoot to telephone wire, consequences clenched jaws. Everybody believes liars. See, verbs swerve on a Newport, exposed nerve on a toothache. News hurts when you're the accused, when the system's counting on you. Doing time, counting times, money, doing time, counting times, money, when the system's counting on you, doing time. Thank you.
Say that you love me. Say that you love me. Say that you love me, baby. Oh, kiss and don't tell, it's classified. Say that my heart is all yours. Say that you love. Oh, say that you love. Kiss is so strong, it's tender. Take me your red lips, release me. Oh, say that you love me, baby. Oh, say that you. Oh, say that you love. Say that you love. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whoa, oh, oh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, say that you love. Whoa, oh, oh. Oh, say that you love. Let it drip from your lips. As sweet as your scent, intoxicating. The beat of my heart as you beat on my chest. I'm breathing you in, it's so divine. I wanna scream out as you're screaming my name. Are we playing games? Oh, I don't know. So say that you love, place your fingers in mine, and say that you're mine. Oh, mine. Well, say that's love. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whoa, oh, oh. yeah, yeah, we'll say that's in love. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, love me, say that you love. Oh, kiss me strongly like it's the last time. Hold on tight and never let go. And say that you love. Oh, screaming from inside, love me. Say that you love. Oh, kiss me strongly like it's the last time. Hold on tight and never let go. And say that you love. From inside, we'll say that you. We're like it's the never let go. Say that, say that. We'll say that's in love. We're like it's the never let go. Say that, say that. Oh, we'll say that's in love. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, love me, love me, love me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll say that's in love. Oh, oh, oh. Ah, yeah, yeah. Say that you love me.
Linger like sneaky Trojan horses. Incremental time releases of destructions that have become so much of our psyche for so long that it doesn't even register anymore that we've been bamboozled. Just accept the perpetual psychosis as the way we are, the way we were, now buried beneath mentally imported detritus. If you deny yourself, if you believe your ancestors unpretty, if you're ashamed of your ancestral tree, then tell me, how does your soul find purchase? How do you buoy yourself when you've unstoppered and drained your genetic pool and are now tethered to a people's tree that your ancestors used to hang from? See, we are now psychologically pinning our hopes on how we look in somebody else's eyes, covering our kinky to enrich Koreans, painting lighter shades on the skin once scooped from the earth, then pasting brightly colored lenses over brown beauties. And meanwhile, as the generations before them flounder, too many of our youth have become willing menaces to the idea of a sane black society. Modern day stepping fetches with a scowl, spouting ridiculous oxymorons like gangster heaven. Clear evidence that we have forgotten the lessons of Malcolm, Rosa, Martin, Sojourner, Marcus, and we don't even know who Shirley Chisholm is anymore. This is where freedom has brought us. Your child can't read, but he's a motor freaking video king. Your child can't divide, but she can pop that thing like there were 1,000 kernels bursting inside. If your teens won't even listen to you, yet still they all have cell phones, then take a look in the mirror at the worker bees at the epicenter of our own destruction. See, this Trojan deception we've accepted into our sense of self is like a virus programmed to reprogram its host into infecting and reinfecting others until it all gurgitating and regurgitating its message as our own. You ain't shh. You ain't shh. You ain't shh. Willingly planting the destructive echoes into the next generation and the next generation until the next generation until so many buy into the Trojan denigration that it gets woven into our songs, you know, cause nizzles just love to party and push and party and push and party till 153 years after the Emancipation Proclamation, we find ourselves making excuses instead of making history. 151 years after Juneteenth, we're making a mockery of the titanic of efforts of those who arose from the bonds of slavery to become carpenters, engineers, doctors, lawyers, bankers, who started their own businesses, who didn't worry about why they would put a grocery store in our neighborhood. No, our predecessors understood. If you don't make and control the things that are necessary for your survival and well-being, then you are constantly dependent upon those who do. Negroes, it's Juneteenth, 2016. And this is what's become the descendants of Black Wall Street. This hand-wringing shell of that once vibrant community. Evidence that the 1921 massacre destroyed not just a place, but a mindset. Because now, Black Tulsans buy from everybody else but Black Tulsans. And nearly 100 years after his heart was set on fire, Greenwood is now Greenwood in name only. Thank you.
We dance. It was a mountain Zion, burning mountain like a Negro Baptist fire. Mortar fire rang out over the tribal chants of children. Prayers of ancestral African Methodist Episcopalian. My Lord, through these tears, convince me that this ain't hell, is it? Yesterday was just the 30th, and church service did feel a little different, but my Lord, my Lord, my Lord, I felt a chill in my spine in the bomb in Gilead. There was a fire shot up in my bones, and I was convinced you came down from heaven. But now there's whispering that that boom was a bomb dropped near Archer. See, the movie theater is gone, and the Stratford's come on too. Now the only song fitting to be hung is Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, coming forward to carry you. See, these stories are home to me now. Graffiti line, concrete for Juneteenth, are manifestos. I'll be sure to tell my son about it. God's providence, his chosen children's prominence, dramatic, acting out in heaven's theater, redemption, five-star, redemption, told as an epic, accompanied by symphony, somewhat Shakespearean, a homeless Iliad, standing room only, audience of angelic, not even one seat in the mezzanine, balcony full two, scene one, anxiety, applause, take place on Guthrie Green, Brady District, ballpark erected, lights on, Friday nights, night owls drink merrily, and hoot, none suspected. The city's only goal is to get this area popping. None suspected. Eat here, dance here, spin here, build here. Hotel erected mission simply fill every street. Reconciliation Park, empty. Orchestra crescendo. None suspected. The images in the statue slowly come to life, start breathing. Ragged suits, tattered dresses, gunshot wounds, third degree burns, women and children carrying their own tombstones, skin scarred, smiles too. They link arms and into the night, marching. See? Modern Hollywood likes to box office thieves as zombies, but not these spirits. Walk these streets and area patrons are frozen fear, none suspecting. But the ones that know, notice that what they feared most has come to life. The truth has been revealed. and it's marching to Zion from Zion. To a lit park in the city's new thriving district. Hundreds of somber, dark, but pale faces stare out into a sea of mixed races. Mostly white, some brown, some red, some yellow. And they slowly rise, frozen short of breath, reaction to a phobia anxiety attack. And then the dead speak as a choir to a congregation. Swing low, sweet chariot. Swing low, sweet chariot. Swing low, sweet chariot. This will always be Black Wall Street. This right here will always be Black Wall Street. Right here, take your shoes off.
Meanwhile, we Trojan descendants nonchalantly bury our brains in the bigotry like ostriches and happily wave our butts in the air to the beatings. Then for some reason, we always seem shocked that others so blatantly take advantage of the opportunities waving before them, and we keep getting fornicated. These brains need an enema, y'all.
No one wants to rock the weight of a city in their arms. Lullaby it to sleep. Especially a city as ugly as you, Tulsa, that wakes constantly, stinking of nightmares and sweat. It was all so real, she says, as she recalls her dreams, her concrete blasted by bombs, sidewalks stained with blood. Worse than anything are the self-inflicted wounds. It was just a bad dream, baby, go back to sleep. But reality beats. And it's time we realize Greenwood was more than a night terror. As we created projects where once there was Wall Street. Yes, we created projects where once there was Wall Street. The most affluent African American community in US history, dubbed Black Wall Street by Booker T. Washington himself. Yet we substituted half-truths for the whole story. Yes, we created projects where once there was Wall Street. And today, a boy at Pine and MLK walked to school with the weight of 5 generations of poverty impacted into the back of his skull like the pop of a 357 SIG from a Glock 9, and no matter how hard he tries, no matter how fast he runs, that little boy has a life expectancy that is 13 years less than a little boy who lives in South Tulsa. I want to know what tragedy sounds like on an off day. Is this is one tragedy we can't afford to downplay. It's this ghetto we made like a grave. Yes, we created projects for once. There was Wall Street. Seems secrets are easier to keep than promises these days, Tulsa.
touch my body. I've been waiting patient and I'm closer now. Rescue my body. Resuscitate my heart, bring me back somehow. Reflex, don't let no time to react. Feel the rock shimmer, but you can't see me coming. When I touch down, I'ma hit the ground running. Get him on the line, catch him from behind. Take back what's mine, I'ma give it 100. Storm through this weather, that means stay ready wherever. For two steps ahead, I'm clever. Team is designed to survive, baby, I'm alive. But I ain't done yet. Turn your back on me, I'ma creep up on ya. Rip my way back just to handle my business. Set the fire, you can be my witness. Yeah, you lost the only me. You're blind before you see.
Look at all these people searching for reason, searching for peace of mind. Hey, say we're all created equal. That's what they teach us, but that ain't how we treat each other. That ain't how we treat each other. Shit, the truth is that we need each other. Yeah! Diamond in the back, babies on crack, kicking the door, waving the ball. White collar war crime, money gets spent. Candles in the sun, blowing in the wind. Sun goes down, heroes often get shot. Pieces long been forgot. Oh, will it be too late when we find out? In the ring of a bit, hey, aren't you appalled? Are we doing? Are we going? What are we doing? Diamond in the back, babies on crack, kicking the door, waving the 4-4. White collar war crime, money gets spent. Candles in the sun, blowing in the wind. Sun goes down, heroes.
Gage, 2016. You guys, if you loved it, let me hear it. Amazing, 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 you guys. Bringing it together, shining your light, making sure that we build that bridge. You guys, I want to just thank you so much for coming out. I know you can't see, but you can hear. I want to introduce to you guys the origin, the idea behind Gage. It's my brother. His name is Larry Crawford. And he's a poet, he's an artist, he's a producer, he's a dancer, he's everything that Gage promotes, and he's a booth full of wisdom. And we sat back a couple of years ago, and I told him, you know what, Gage is where it's at. We need to come up with a production together and produce something that incorporates music, art, fashion, and a message, particularly about Tulsa, particularly about our past and slavery and how we overcome. And so you guys, he's my rock, and he's just, you know, he's my baby brother, kind of big brother sometimes. And I just want him to give you guys some words just to leave home with, you guys. Larry Crawford, please give it up.
I just want to thank everybody for coming out. You know, everybody looks real good. See some familiar faces. And I'm happy to see that after all these years, it's really coming together as we planned. It's beautiful. So thank you. Everybody give the band one more round of applause, please.
Brian Lamar.
Yeah, you got it, man. And that's it, y'all. Have a blessed day.
Wonderful. You guys, thank you. Ados, Brian Lamar, you guys, Oramat, you guys, what do you think about that choreography? Oramat, Monique Sims, you guys, thank you so much. Oramat, you're amazing. I love you so much. Marissa Joy, you guys, Dina came out, you guys, the poetry was amazing. Happy Father's Day to you guys. I also want to say thank you so much for my baby, my two, Tamaya and Tim. Happy Father's Day, baby. Thank you so much for helping us come together. Tony B, you're amazing. Ridden, Patoti, Claire, you guys, Selah Models, Brett, you're amazing. You guys, thank you so much. Monique, I love you. You guys, you're terrific. Thank you so much for everybody that's a part of this. Danae, you're awesome. You guys, and that last song, you guys, that was me singing and rapping on there, produced by Brian Lamar, so that's awesome. Gage 2016. If you guys enjoyed yourselves, let me hear you say Gage 2016 on 1, 2, 3. Gage 2016 at the Living Arts. Thank you so much, Steve Liggett.
Say that's love. Oh, oh, oh.